Developing right now, a search for a killer in South Florida after an up-and-coming rapper is shot dead. 20-year-old XXXTentacion killed in an apparent robbery. Police say the artist, whose real name is Jose Onfroy, was leaving a Broward County motorcycle shop yesterday when he was shot by two men who ran up to his car. He was rushed to a hospital but did not make it. Onfroy's death comes just weeks after he earned his first number one album, which debuted March 31st.
Hello, my YouTubers. Thank you for coming to watch my video. So today I wanted to do this video on Jose Onfroy. And this is the young rapper XXXTentacion. He was very well known, and he was murdered on June 18th, 2018. So since today is June 18th, I thought I would do this today, get this out, and I hope you guys enjoy. I do Vedic astrology, and I just decided to start doing birth charts of people that have already passed, and I just love doing it because it's just my passion. I love to see what energies create people to be who they are or who they were. And so I thought I would start doing the videos and share it with you. And thank you for watching. So Jose Onfroy was born January 23rd, 1998 in Plantation, Florida. I don't have the time of birth, but I am just doing it by his moon. Hindu astrology, they usually go by the moon anyways. They put the moon in the first house and then they go from there. But I'm going to just start with putting the moon in his first house since I do not know his time of birth. So he was a Scorpio moon, and this Scorpio moon is, when you see Scorpio moon, for me anyways, I see Scorpio as a deep person that is very, they can be, they're just deep lovers, they're deep feelers, they think very deeply about things, they're very intuitive, they can have that psychic ability, and also the moon stands for your mother as well, so his mom was probably very intelligent with that. His mom is probably psychic herself. She has that psychic ability. She has that intuition. And so this is a placement that creates a person to be either, it's ruled by Mars. So Mars is a warrior. There are people that are fighters. They can be fighters. They might be a little scrappy. But this is also about a person that's just a deep warrior. They will fight for and stand up for what they believe in. And so his nakshatra that it sets in is Indardra, and that is about a lotus, or it's about the arches. And these people are very, they are very deep feelers. They are leaders. They are people that can be good mentors. They like to, they can speak and people will listen to them. And so these people are also very, it's like they've had a lot of heartbreaks in their life just because they are deep feelers. Because, you know, Scorpio is the deep oceans, it's the deep of the water, and these people, they feel really deeply. So whenever they get into relationships, they can connect to people very deeply. And so this brings to having the heart, a lot of heartbreaks, and these heartbreaks can lead into a lot of creativity. And whenever you've been through a lot, you can express yourself and figure out how to get through those times of your life that made you so deeply sad.
Questions asked, but it was just at the time when she was younger, my mom was 17-18 with a baby, and I mean her nigga not paying her no mind, she ain't have nobody around, you feel me? So she was just hustling, trying to get out of mud. She was passing me hand to hand and shit. So it was like,
so you at grandma house, you with, yeah.
Initially it wasn't even just that, like, mm-hmm. She, like, to friends and shit, you know what I'm saying, our babysitters and like distant family and shit like that, it was nothing really too close. So I grew up having to self-soothe, but imagine having to self-soothe and not doing it and just being like mentally ill from the very beginning and just being depressed from the very beginning. Mm. And I mean this like, and I'm saying this like from my heart, like that's really what it was.
So the second house for the moon, he has Mercury and Venus setting there, and it is in Sagittarius. Mercury is setting at 20 degrees of Sagittarius, which is Porpha Shada. And this is about finding the true meaning of life, finding that pure innocence of love as well. It's about that encouragement, philosophy, and sharing it with people. And these people are very direct whenever they talk as well. But these people are also just trying to find justice, trying to find the true meaning, the true belief, the true essence of life. They love to help others as well. They're into, you know, humanity. They want to help humans and evolve into something that is about love, you know. These people are also people that are warriors. They're determined. They have a lot of determination. They also want to help people, you know, they just want to help people better themselves. And for this being Mercury, Mercury is about communication. It's about speaking. And so it's about, and so is Venus, really, because Venus's natural house is the second house, and that is about speech. It's about your mouth. And so this could mean also that he had a beautiful mouth, but he spoke in a way that shared love. He wanted to share the true essence of life in a loving way, not as a harsh way, but as in a loving way, to teach others to know what is their surroundings, what is the honest truth, right?
There is no such thing. Well, sorry, there is no such thing. No one can tell you who to be. So in purpose, you have to create your own purpose. And in evolution, you have to evolve towards that purpose. It's easier to live when you have goals to meet. You understand? If you have goals to meet, then you don't feel so voided, and you understand why every day you're looking at this person in the mirror, because that is the cool part about the game. You get to be anybody you want to be.
Also about these people are very popular, they're very talented, they love music, and a lot of people recognize them for their talent and for their musical abilities. These people are also fearless. It's like they really don't give two craps about what people think about them and what people believe or whatever. They just do what they want to do, and they express the way that they feel philosophically, no matter what people think.
I want to teach everybody to do what the fuck I'm doing, and if I'm not doing that, then I'm a fake bitch. If I'm not teaching people how to make money, if I'm not teaching people how to love themselves, if I'm not teaching people how to do everything they want to do with their life, then who the fuck am I? If I'm not teaching you how to do better with your life, I'm not your brother or your friend. I'm a fuck.
So his sun sets in Capricorn, and it is at 9 degrees in Capricorn, and that is the nakshatra Adha Barapada. And this is about being respected. They are very respectful people, and they are about protection. They want to protect their heritage as well. They're into their heritage, and they are very forgiving people. This next chakra is about being having forgiveness, and these people are very kind to others, and for their forgiveness that they do in this lifetime, they're able to pass to the next lifetime and have their karma clear because of the forgiveness that they have in this lifetime. But these people like to live by the water, because this is about deep waters, and they can be very they have that psychic ability and know the deep knowledge of the unknown. But these people have the ability to know things before other people, or just have that psychic ability. But sometimes these people can feel alone by themselves and kind of empty.
Ideally, like, control, but to just manifest that type of energy, I want to see, like, I want to just have more power in the aspect of trying to, like, all right, I know what the kids want. I know what we all desire. I understand things, and I feel like that's why I've been placed in such an important position, because I understand things, and I just understand how people feel in the aspect of, okay, I know how it feels to be alone. I know how it feels to be around people and feel alone. Like, I'll be around a million people and I'll, like, still feel alone. Like, even sometimes, like, all right, like, I'll go out even with my own friends, like my previous friends, and I just would feel alone. And
next he has Jupiter. Jupiter and Mars setting in Aquarius, and they're both setting in the nakshatra of Dhanishta. Dhanishta is about the is the richest nakshatra, and so these people have the riches in life. They become rich, and they are very talented by their music. It can be about artwork. It can be about that feeling of music, but also this nakshatra can feel alone as well. They kind of feel like they're separated from other people, but they can be very materialistic, but they're very musical as well. But these people are people that love to travel. They like to go overseas. They like the finer things in life. But they are also people that are very understanding. They believe that they can listen to others and understand what they are going through and feel their passion for other people when they are in need of a friend. So next is K2. K2 sets in Aquarius in Shatabisha. And Shatabisha is about, it's a circle. It's a circle with a void in the middle. And that represents that void that you fill. Those people have a void and they're always searching to fill that void. In other words, they will go to the deepest, darkest to find knowledge to fill that void. And so they are always seeking for that knowledge, seeking for the truth. And they also are people that like to, they're also 100 healers is what the nakshatra is as well. And so these people like to use natural herbs to heal. They're also people that like to be cleansing through eating healthy, like they could be a vegan or a vegetarian, and they kind of use that in a spiritual way. These people are known, shamans are known to have this placement as well, but these people are also known to be good astrologers or astronomy. They are really good in astronomy. They want to look at the stars. They want to know what's beyond what we see, what is beyond here. But they are very good healers as well, and they can use those herbs and natural remedies to heal others. That's just how they are. They have that ability. So his Saturn sets in Revati, and Revati is in Pisces. So what is Pisces? Pisces is about the 12th house energy. It is jail, hospitals, sale asylums, any place that you have to be alone and solitude. And so it's also dreams, the other side, the ability to have also just intuition as well. And so he has Saturn setting here. Saturn is about learning lessons in life, but wherever Saturn sits, you do learn your lessons in life. It's just a hard, it's just that lesson that you have to learn. So for him, sleeping might have been, sometimes he didn't sleep very well. Sometimes he could have slept a lot. But in his sleep, Revati is about sleeping. Finding things will come to you in your sleep. You will learn things in your sleep, in your dreams. Dreams will teach you things. And if you think about the video that he made that was released right after his death, and it is about a dream. And so that's pretty cool because that is Revati. Revati is about dreams. It is about learning in your dreams. But these people also are people that like to travel. They like to go to foreign lands. They also like water. They like to live by the water. These people are also people that like to donate their time. They like to give to charity. They like to do for humanity. And it is about the love of humanity. It's about sharing what is good to the earth, and to it's also about meditation and learning the mystical side of energy. And we know that he was all into that. At the end of his time, he was an old soul. He already knew the things that other people could never even imagine. But through his whole entire his whole entire chart, though, he has been having, you know, it's all about humanity and loving and learning and being kind to others and giving his charity, giving to others, being forgiveness, having forgiveness, being very kind to others. So this is the kind of person he was. This is why he was loved. A lot of his music was very straightforward, and but that was his talent. He could make music that reached out to others and that created this certain energy for his music, and that's what people loved about him.
This challenge, the way to participate in this challenge is basically whoever makes the most donations gets to meet me, spend a day with me, gets to go out to dinner with me, giggle with me, play video games, and get like a shout out and just simple, something simple, and maybe even $1,000 reward. I'm considering it. I was told I shouldn't do $1,000 reward, but I'll be considering it. But long story short, I'll fly you out, spend the day with you. You know what I'm saying? Be a part of the vlog. It'll be a cool reward. But basically, to participate, the one that wins is the one who documents and helps the most, not only homeless, but the most people in need. It can be any form of person in need, even if it's like going to a shelter or just even feeding the homeless. Whoever does the most good.
Is it, you want to go to the Air Force, or you want to go to infantry, or you want to go to the Navy? So you think about infantry, okay, that's brave. What do you want to do?
A lawyer.
A lawyer? What do you want to do?
A lawyer.
A lawyer? That's great, actually. That's going to require a lot of schooling, so y'all got to make sure you remain content. Which one? You want to run track? Okay. What you want to do? A doctor?
So let's talk about his karma planets, which is K2 and Rahu. And wherever Rahu is, that's what you're here to learn in this lifetime. And wherever K2 is what you learned in your last past life. And so for him, he has Rahu that is sitting in Leo. And so here for this lifetime, he was supposed to learn about his ego and about his father as well, because son is the father, and that is what rules what rules Leo. And so there is a story, or there is something that he was supposed to learn about his father, also being a fun, outgoing, childlike. And then a K2 set in Aquarius. And Aquarius is about humanity. It's about eating healthy. It's about the Kundalini, learning your Kundalini, and learning the third eye powers. And it's about that. And so it's also about giving to others and letting go. And then you have, that is where you're supposed to balance out in life. So for him, he was supposed to balance out giving to others and being selfish. And he had to learn how to equal those out. That's just a little bit of his karma in this lifetime, what he needed to do. But for the most part, he was so very giving and loving, and he was forgiving, but he was a deep lover, very psychic. He was very happy to reach out to others and teach others about what he knew about the spiritual side of life. And not a lot of people understand that, or will never understand that, will never feel like they have any other kind of belief. Some people just stay in the box of society and what society expects and what society wants. And he was trying to reach out to others to see, show them the ability of reaching out and being different than others and giving to society, helping the people that need to be helped.
Tragic death or some shit, and I'm not able to see out my dreams, I at least want to know that the kids perceived my message and were able to make something of themselves and able to take my message and use it and turn it into something positive and to at least have a good life. I at least, if I'm gonna die or ever be a sacrifice, I want to make sure that my life made at least 5 million kids happy, or they found.
Thank you guys for watching my video, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Make sure you smile, share, smile with someone, and thanks for watching. Like, share, and comment. Deuces. Yeah.
that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go.